Hey, shalom, shalom, everyone. This is Chris Shoemaker, also known as Yehuda ben Shomer, and welcome to the Daily Drash. Today's Daily Drash is taken from Psalm 103, verse 12, and it says, "How far has the Lord taken our sins from us? Farther than the distance from the east to the west." Now, how far is that? How far is the east is from the west? But before we get into that, how far is north to south? Well, you know, let's just say that this is our globe, this is our planet, right? And God has taken our sins and throwing them as far as the north is from the south. And let's say we're here at the equator and he throws away our sin. And it goes north, 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 and guess what? You hit the equator and you start going south. South, 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 and boom, the sin comes back to hit you in the face. It returns to you. But God didn't say he throws our sins as far as the north is from the south. He says he throws our sins as far as the east is from the west. And if you go in an easterly direction, you're never going to go west. You're going to keep going east, always going east. And if you go west, you're never going to hit east. You're going to keep going, in that direction. So as far as the east is from the west, it is an infinite line that will never meet or never touch. So, you know, if you keep going in this direction and in an easterly direction, you're still going east, going east, going east, and you don't meet west. You just keep going. And so God throws our sins as far as the east is from the west. So in other words, God never brings up our dirty laundry or brings up past sins that has been forgiven. You know, it's not like us with human beings. Whenever we get into an argument with our spouse or with our coworkers or with our friends, if they really want to, you know, dig into us and they really want to, drive their point home, they're going to dig up and bring something up that you did a week ago, a month ago, a year ago, several years ago. Oh yeah, but remember when you did this? Just like, oh my goodness, can you let that go? It just shows that the other person really hasn't forgiven you of that thing or that issue that had happened. But that's not like it is with God. When we ask for forgiveness, he forgives us. Let's look at some other passages too. I like it. I like the passage in Micah 7:19, and it says, speaking of God, you trample on our sins and throw them in the sea. You know, there's a place called Mariana's Trench, and it's the deepest place on Earth. And it's so deep that they haven't come up with the technology for submarines to go to the bottom without being crushed like a soda can. And so nobody has explored the very, very depths of certain places on this planet, in the ocean, in the sea. It's down there. It's in the dark. It never sees the light of day. It'll never be found. It'll never be brought up again. And so that's what God does with our sins when he forgives us. He throws them into the sea of forgetfulness and remembers them no more. And this is a beautiful allusion to the Tashlik service, the service, the traditional service we have after Yom Kippur, where we throw stones into a living body of water, a lake or a stream. You know, you throw that stone into the water, you're not going to find it again. It's going to sink to the bottom and it's going to be forgotten. You're never going to, even if you dive and try to look for that stone, you will not find that same stone. It's virtually impossible. And let's look at another passage. I like this one too, where it says, Isaiah 1:18, "I, the Lord, invite you to come and talk it over. Your sins are scarlet red, but they will be whiter than snow or wool." You know, a crimson stain is, especially in biblical times, was impossible to get out. The best you could do is turn it to a faded pink color, right? But he says that he's going to take our sins, which will stain just like scarlet and get into the fibers of the wool just like scarlet, and they're there, they're permanent. You can't undye wool. You just can't do it. But he says that he's going to take our sins just like dyed wool, and he's going to turn them white again. He's going to do the impossible, and he's going to make it as if the scarlet dye, the scarlet stain has never touched that wool. Only God could do that. He not only just forgives our sins, he not only just covers our sins, but he actually takes them away. He dissolves them and makes them as if they never existed. And 1 Corinthians 13:5 says, "Love isn't selfish." Now, what's the definition of love? Go to 1 John. It says God is love. He is the very definition of love. So it says love, or we can put in here, God isn't selfish or quick-tempered. God does not keep records of wrong like others do. So when we sincerely ask forgiveness in Yeshua's name, God forgives us. He doesn't remember it. Even though we might remember it, we might still feel guilty of something that we did that God has already forgiven us, but God doesn't remember it. Say, "God, remember what I did and ask forgiveness for it. Please forgive me again." He's like, "What? I don't even know what you're talking about. I don't remember this. What are you talking about?" So we know that when this happens, it's the enemy that's bringing it up and say, "Nope, enemy, Satan, I've been forgiven of that. I rebuke you in the name of Yeshua, and I command you to go because I've been forgiven. And these scriptures back that up. So go out. So if you've messed up, that's okay. We all mess up. We sin. We're human. We're fallen. Just ask for forgiveness and take those verses as rock solid promise and go out into your day and just release that guilt and know that you've been forgiven and you've been given a fresh start. Have a great day, folks. Shalom, Shavuot Tov.